The Diary of Lambert Giovanni Di Michele. Composer, man of letters, lover. August 1791. Milan. I have been toiling of late, for I am commissioned to compose a new opera for the Duke. My music has greatly pleased him. The people of the city open with their affections. The ladies do flitter and flutter their fans as I walk in the pleasure gardens. The men of mode and macaronis bow and fawn before me at court. Yet all is not well. For even now, quill bristling in my hand, I find myself distracted. Mine eye meandering from the page and across the chamber to the rococo cabinet at its far wall. Oh, but to describe its beauty with words alone. That asymmetrical symmetry. Lustrous walnut hue. What vulgar delight I feel, glimpsing two pairs of delicately gilded legs. Gaze roving up its curvilinear form, its rounded bombay. This was beauty, the like of which I had never seen before. I try to return to the composition before me, but the music has lost all color on the page. It is late, and I must to bed. Up, and the dawn brings with it no comfort. All night long I tossed and turned betwixt my linens, sleep eluding me most entirely. The morning light fills the room, and my mahogany mistress now takes on a fresh, rosy air. How has this inanimate piece enchanted me so? I approach, and in so doing catch my reflection in the cabinet's glass. Horns protruding from beneath a wig, eyes visible behind a mask. It is a wonder that those haunted bulls I see in their sunken sockets belong to me. Woe upon woe, how you expose me like no other. In your veneer do I see mine own. September 1791, Milan. Tonight my opera was played before a packed La Scala. Oh, how they whooped and bravoed, bellowing for every note. But their elation turned to ash in my ear. For my mind was not there, but here. Here with the bounteous bureau in my boudoir. By the grace of God, what sorcery is this? That I, master of my craft, could be reduced to a bumbling, lovesick fool. For 'tis true, I love thee to distraction. Venus and Adonis, my life is in servitude to you alone. October. 1791. San Remo. I have left for my palazzo on the Ligurian coast, close to the city of San Remo. I hope the sea air may go some way in rousing me from my melancholy state. But alas, there is but an infinite multitude, for in my fervid sleep, the cabinet comes again. Doors opening wide as if in embrace. Then comes the terrible jealousy towards my sweet commode's creator, the intimate moments shared in its making. Oh, how I envied the hand that overlaid that parcel gilt, the fingers tracing every tongue and groove. Painted harlot! You have ruined me, and begads, I will ruin you. I ride through the night, besodden with drink, and reach my lodgings before the day's break. Bursting through the chamber, I can make out by the candlelight that most lovely and malicious form. I allow my hand to briefly rest upon my sculpted seductress, before bringing the axe down upon its frame. Endless misery. Each splintery blow is a blow upon my very soul. Soon, morning comes, and I lie slumped amongst the shattered ruins of my heart's ligneous desires. I have nothing left for this world. I am coming, my love. I must depart this life. Watch you!